So we've seen that innovation is all about survival and growth. But survival is not compulsory. Now, at one level, it's obvious. Mm. If we don't change what we offer the world and the ways we create and deliver that offering, we may not be around. But what about the companies that get that and still don't survive? Well, let's look at a few examples. No one could accuse Kodak of being a stupid company. Like our earlier examples, founded by an entrepreneur, George Eastman, a brilliant idea that wasn't just a technology, but a way of using it. A paradigm change, moving the idea of photography from the specialist photographer's studio to everyone's home. It was very simple. You buy a box Brownie camera, and the slogan made it clear what happened. You point and shoot, click, and we'll do the rest. We'll handle the developing and the printing, and you get back pictures. Wonderful, an innovation which for his company was enormously powerful. That's a company that over most of its life was extremely successful. It became a household name. And yet, despite its growth to being a large global corporation, Kodak is in deep trouble. It's not dead, but it's in Chapter 11 bankruptcy, struggling to survive a fraction of its former size. Now, this might seem a bit of a paradox. How can you be a really smart, innovative player committed to innovation and still have problems? Well, the answer may lie in what Charles Darwin said. Remember, he said, it's not the strongest of the species that survive, nor the most intelligent. It's the one that's most adaptable to change. And that adaptable to change is something that matters over time. So Kodak were able to ride a wave or ride several waves of change to their advantage, new technologies, new markets, and so on. The thing that was a problem for Kodak was learning to deal with something they invented, the digital camera. And actually, the problem was that the world and the way they wanted to consume what the digital camera made possible was not something that Kodak were aligned well enough with. Now, it's not an easy trick. Kodak didn't necessarily make a lot of mistakes. It's very easy to say they were stupid. They certainly weren't stupid, but their ability to innovate under those new conditions wasn't sufficient.